Samples were belongings from Mr. Arafat that were containing visible biological stains. That means they have been used, and we knew that he was wearing this clothing at the hospital. So we did measurements on these particular stains. These levels were substantial. They were significantly different, which shows that there is an abnormal, not normal quantity of polonium.
But you found unsupported polonium in these specific items?
Yes, we did. We did find some not supported polonium in these samples.
Al Jazeera's Clayton Swisher worked on the investigation and sent this report.
In the coming hours, investigators from France, Switzerland, and Russia will begin the slow process of unearthing the body of former Palestinian leader Yasser Arafat from his gravesite in Ramallah. Now, this comes a full 8 years after the iconic Palestinian leader died a mysterious death in a one-month illness, and nearly 5 months since the broadcast of our exclusive documentary, What Killed Arafat. In that film, scientists with the Institute for Radiation Physics in Lausanne, Switzerland, discovered significant levels of reactor-made polonium-210 in Arafat's biological samples. This highly lethal radioisotope was measured in a blood stain from Arafat's hospital cap, a urine stain from the underwear he wore when checking into the hospital, his toothbrush, and the sweat-stained collar from his athletic jumper. Now, following Al Jazeera's broadcast, Arafat's widow Suha petitioned a French court to open a murder investigation, which they later did. Now, the Palestinian Authority elected to invite the same Swiss lab used by Al Jazeera in our documentary to continue on with their radiological tests today. And they've also in recent weeks invited the Russians to participate. It'll be some time before those test results are back, perhaps months, but it may be the surefire way to know, once and for all, whether or not Yasser Arafat was murdered.